I watch the news, President Clinton, he in some bullshit. I like President Clinton. I like a president that get a nut. We ain't had a president get a nut in a long time, y'all. You know George wasn't fucking Barbara. Look at that bitch. We ain't even sure she a woman. What the fuck you talking about? And if Reagan did get a nut, he don't remember it. I like President Clinton because he said he want to be just like the Kennedys, but that motherfucker should have called Ted to drop Monica's ass off, shouldn't he? Because Ted know how to drop a bitch off, don't it? Ted will drop you some water and go, oops, in a minute. And this whole Monica Lewinsky thing ain't nothing but hoe tricks. I know hoe tricks when I see them. I ain't never been no hoe, but I've been hoe-ish. It's a difference. You got Hillary Clinton, the first hoe. Jennifer Flowers, an old hoe. Monica Lewinsky, a lying hoe. And Linda Tripp, an old bitter hoe. See, you can't have a bitter hoe and a lying hoe hanging out together. That's a whole catastrophe. And what kind of bitch keep a dress with jizz on it? Oh, you a nasty stank asshole. You got a dress with jizz on it. They need to call Monica Krusty the Clown. You know what I'm saying? And what are we really talking about? It's not like she could do it well. It got all over everything, didn't it? Every time Monica come, here come the janitor. That bitch don't know what she doing. She need to learn how to suck, swirl, swallow. Suck, swirl, swallow. That's why in the next election, you need to vote for me. You know where you stand with me. You know damn well I ain't gonna light no joint and not in hell. That's a waste of money. If I was your president, my first State of the Union address wouldn't be no longer than 2-3 minutes. Wouldn't be fucking with your football game, your soap opera, your movie of the week, because they know that shit's important to you. I'd be on TV talking about, hey, I'm President Thea, how you doing, how you doing? My niggas. Just want to tell y'all that everything's okay. If I was your president, I'd have every country in the world afraid of America the way they used to be. They ain't scared of us no more. But I put the fear of God in their ass for you. I wouldn't have to go to the UN, but one time I go, hey, I'm President Thea. You might want to listen up. I know you didn't say nothing, Libya. What? I'll fuck your bitch ass up. Don't get it twisted. I didn't think so. You will notice that each of you have been given a calendar. You will notice on said calendar that the number 20 is circled in red. This is when I start my period. You don't want to fuck with me around this time of the month. I will bomb your country and build a fucking mall. Don't fuck with me! And just so that you know that your concerns are my concerns, I even got my own crime bill. Sure do. The way I got it figured, every first Monday of the month ain't shit good on TV no way. So every first Monday of the month, Thea will be cleaning death row. Now some of y'all are saying, Thea, how will you clean death row? Well, everybody on death row will be dead. If you a child killer, we'll kill you. If you a rapist, we cut your dick off, put in a jelly jar. You get to visit it 30 minutes on your birthday if you act right. So when you're voting, just sign my name in. I hear somebody getting married in the back. That's all fine and well. But there's some shit you might want to think about. And I'm the bitch to tell you. I've been married for 17 years, and I can honestly tell you ladies that I rate sex right up there with cleaning the oven and defrosting the refrigerator. It's a dirty job, but somebody gotta do it. I have faking an orgasm down to a science. Wow! Baby, baby, wow! Baby, baby, wow! Can we go to the mall now? Anyway. The first thing you need to know about a man is, one, men think they know everything. But he don't know enough to wipe their behinds, because I can get you 10 men up here and 7 of them got skid marks in their underwear. If you know so much, how come you can't wipe your ass? Who the fuck want to see your shitty drawers, your low-down dirty trifling bastards? let that out. Thank you. Rule number two. Men think that women aren't good drivers, but we're good drivers, aren't we, girls? That's right. We can hit just as much shit as they can, and we don't have to be drunk to do it. Yeah, my first accident was with a policeman. I was driving along, and I lost control of my car. So I accidentally run into him, but that motherfucker saw me lose control. He should have moved. If it don't mean shit to you, it don't mean shit to me. And you never want your husband in the car as a passenger, because they think you don't see shit. You know how you be driving along going, baby, that's a red light. I didn't ask you that. Turn your blinker on. Look, nigga, don't start no shit, okay? The light's green. Get the fuck out the car! Three, men know nothing about their children. They know nothing, because your child can fall down and go back to playing all day long, but soon as his daddy come through that door, he'll go, look, daddy, daddy, look, daddy, look, daddy, look, look, daddy, look. And this is what your husband will say, woman, why did you let him fall? I didn't let him fall, I pushed him down. If you don't like what the fuck I do, take him to work with you where you go. I bet you'll knock him against the wall a couple times. But the worst thing in the world about a man is that they will fart anywhere. And if you get a bunch of men together, they'll harmonize. Now, I'll be honest with you. When I was in love with my husband, I used to let him do it in the house. But then we had children, we bought him pets and such. Honey, he let one loose, he killed the dog, the bird. I have never seen a fish try to hold its breath. And men have the nerve to have favorite places they like to do it. My husband's favorite place is the supermarket, because he'll be pushing the cart up ahead of me, and I'll be walking behind him, and he'll let one of these leg lifters loose and leave me walking into it. And it's like a time tunnel. You can't get out. Honey, did you do that? It slipped out. I don't think so, baby, because you got a hole in your pants and a green cloud following you. And the manager screaming, clean up on aisle 8.